kasi nakukulkul eh. Okay, good morning.
Morning.
Okay, Kuya Willie, Ron, good morning. This morning, we'll be sharing the two parts message. Kasi 53 slides ito, katiin ko lang. It talks about what does God want? It sounds like a simple question. Ano ba gusto ng Diyos? Pero maraming Kristiyan, hindi alam kung anong gusto ng Diyos. They only assume na ito ang gusto ng Diyos. And they do it religiously. And they think they please God. That's why in the end of the day, diba sabi ni Lord, tanol ka, pagdating doon sa langit, maraming magsasabi na, Lord, nagpalayas ako ng demonyo. Lord, nagsalita ako sa ibang wika. So, di ba? Sabi niya, umalis kayo sa harap ako, I don't know you. Di ba? Then meron pa siyang statement na sinabi niya, nung ako'y nagutom, hindi niyo ako pinakain. Nung ako'y nauhaw, hindi niyo ako binigyan ng tubig. So, di ba? Nung ako'y nakulog, hindi niyo ako dinalaw. So whatever you do to the least of the brethren, you're doing it to me. So, most of the time, we assume na alam natin kung anong gusto ng Diyos. But this morning, we'll talk about what the Bible says, ano ba talaga ang gusto ng Diyos? Bakit nga pala tayo nilikha ng Diyos? Para saan? Diba? So, sounds like a simple question, but it's not. Why? People will ask it for a lot of different reasons. Maraming rason, bakit niya tinatanong, ano ang gusto ng Diyos? Maaring gusto niya i-please si Lord. So, ano ang unang reason? It is a cry of anger from someone in pain. Diba? Paggalit, pag may pain ng tao, lalo may sakit, ano ba talaga gusto mo, Lord? Diba? So, misigaw na ganun eh. Out of pain. They will ask God, ano ba talaga gusto mo, Lord? Ginawa ko na nga lahat eh, ganito pa rin. Oh, di ba? Out of any, ano, anger. Another one is, perhaps it is barely an audible whisper that surfaces from deep sadness. But the last, an audible question will surface from, ano, deep sadness. They will ask God, Lord, ano ba talaga gusto mo? Bakit mo ko pinarurusahan ng ganito? Bakit mo ko pinahihirapan ng ganito? Di ba? They will ask that question. And then, it is the motivation of curiosity. Yun ang mga iba, curious lang. Matanong nga, ano ba talaga gusto ng Diyos? Pero wala naman siyang seryosong decision na sundin kung ano gusto ng Diyos. Paano lang? Kere ko lang. Gusto ko lang, parang ano. Or, it is just prompted by the desire to reflect and think deep thoughts. Deep thoughts. Maisip na lang. Bakit nga ba talaga ako nilita ng Diyos? Ano talaga gusto niya sa akin? Out of curiosity. So, what does God want? Palagay niyo, ano gusto ng Diyos?
Worship.
Worship? Ang gusto ng Diyos? Pamilya.
Katulad mong sinabi ng Willie.
Happy ka.
Happy ka. Gusto ko, happy ka. Oh. I'm really asking, what does God want when it comes to every person in the human race? Not individually. Kasi pwede natin sagutin yan individually kung anong gusto ni Lord. In reference to us as a person. But the question is, what God wants when it comes to every person in the human race? Now, for the answer, it is simple.
God wants you.
He wants you.
You.
Okay? Bakit na ba ang gusto ni Lord tayo? Okay? It is not only about what God wants, but it's about things God wants you to know. May gusto siyang malaman natin. Gusto niya malaman natin itong truth na ito. It's not only about He wants you, but about things God wants you to know. What's that? He wants you to appreciate that God wants you, and hopefully you feel the same way about God, that you also want God. Bakit hopefully? Because God gave us freedom. He gave us a choice to want Him or not to want Him. So God wanted a family. From the very beginning, He wanted a family. God does what He does to enjoy what He has done. God didn't create humanity because He lacks something. Sometimes nakala natin, nilikha ng Diyos ang tao kasi kailangan ng Diyos na may mag-worship sa Kanya. Hindi, oy. Bakit? He wasn't lonely. As though He was incomplete or needed a company. Hindi man siya yung single na babae o single na lalaki na naghahanap ng asawa. God doesn't need us. He is complete. He is God. Tama? God needs nothing because He is God. So why God created us? Why He wants a family? He created things to enjoy the work of His own hands. Kaya sabi na rin, gusto ko happy kayo. Si Lord, He created us because He wants to enjoy us. And the things that He cares about most are those He made to be like Him in His own image, as the Bible says. Gusto niyang i-enjoy tayo. And in return, gusto rin niya na tayo mag-enjoy sa Kanya. Because we are created in His own image. Okay? So, the story of why God wants us begins with the biblical idea that God is our creator. Yan yan, simula. The story begins when He created us to be in His own image and likeness. God wanted us to exist in order to enjoy us and to have enjoy Him in return. So, hindi ko really yun. Kaya, ang daming tao hindi nag-i-enjoy sa church. At karamihan tao, ayaw nang umatin ng church. Because they don't enjoy God. Because they think God is killjoy. They think God is something that a demanding God that demand so many things in them na hindi na nila kayang ibigay. Kaya pagsinin mo yung mga sermon sa simbahan, ang daming demand. Di ba? Dapat gawin nyo ito, dapat gawin nyo yan, dapat magpaganito kayo, at iwasan nyo ang ganyan. And tuloy, ay, ang hirap naman pala na maging Kristiyano. So, hindi na sa kanila enjoyable yung ano, Christian life. Because what they meant, the message they're hearing is not about God wanted us to exist in order to enjoy us. Okay? Because God created us, the Bible refers to Him as our Father. Liwanag yun. Kaya nga, we've been telling people that it is not enough that you know Jesus. Because eternal life is knowing God the Father and His Son, Jesus. So, hindi kumpleto kung si Jesus lang. Hindi kumpleto kung Holy Spirit lang. Should be Trinity. So we have three chairs here. And people from Adam onward as His children. So He is the Father and we are His children. That was the concept. So that's why the Bible uses the language of family to describe God and His relationship to us. That no coincidence. That's no coincidence. Hindi coincidence na ang tawag sa Kanya, Father. In the Old Testament, He has more than 300 names. But only in the New Testament, Jesus revealed Him as a Father. So the Bible tells us that before God created us, He has already created other intelligent beings. Listen to it. Bago niya nilikha tayo ni Lord, bago tayo nilikha si Adan at Eva, meron na siyang nilikha na nauna sa atin. Ang tawag dyan na yun, sons of God, Bnei Elohim. These are the spirit being. Kaya ito yung sinasabi ng Biblia ng Genesis 1:26, let us make man. Sino yung us? That was not the Trinity. Why? Number one, reason. The Bible is written by people that are monotheistic, ang belief. God is one. Okay? New Testament lang na-reveal yung Trinity. Second, the reason why it is us is because when God said, let us make man, if that is God, yung Trinity ang kausap niya, why the Father has to inform Jesus and the Holy Spirit? Di ba? Eh, omniscient dapat sila, di ba? Pero pansin ninyo, sumunod na verse, and God created man and woman, male and female. So, hindi nakasama yung us, si Lord na lang. Nakuha nyo? So, in other words, there are what? Sons of God, nauna sa atin. Kaya ang sabi ng Psalm, sabi niya, you were created a little lower than Elohim. Those Elohim are the sons of God. The Bible calls them sons of God. We call them angels. The Old Testament, book of Jacob, Job, tell us that the sons of God shouted for joy when God laid the foundation of the earth. You can read it in Job 38. Nung tinanong si Job, Job, alam mo ba kung paano ko nilikha ang mundo? And sinabi niya, when I created the heavens and the earth, the sons of God shouted for joy. So ibig sabihin, yung sons of God were there. Satan is part of the sons of God. Nag-rebelde nga lang. They are the Elohim of God. Okay? So, what does a phrase like children of God imply? Family. So before God created a human family, there was a what? A spiritual family. Kaya natatawa nga ako eh. Alam mo yung atheist? Hindi naniniwala sa Diyos. Alam mo ba, ang atheism hindi galing kay Satanas? Tama? Kasi si Satanas naniniwala saan? Sa Diyos.
Nanginginig
pa kasi sa takot eh. Kaya sabi ko, mas malala pa kayo kay Satanas. Na you're denying God. And even the devil himself, the author of wickedness, cannot deny God.
Ayaw lang nila.
Di ba?
Hindi na.
Oh, in the case of Job 38, the family is a heavenly or supernatural one. There is a supernatural family. God is the father of the intelligent beings he created in the unseen realm. Kinalala mo nung nagkasala si Adan at Eva, anong sabi ni Lord? Men became one of us. Anong ibig sabihin ni Lord? Yung mga Elohim, mga sons of God, many sons of God, mayroon silang freedom. They know the right and wrong. Nung kinawa ni Lord ang tao, hindi nila alam yung right and wrong. Ang alam lang nila, love. Ang alam lang nila, yung magbahalag. They don't have any idea of what is right and what is wrong. And the moment they eat that tree of the knowledge of good and evil, they become one of them. Who is them? These are the Elohim. The sons of God. So, when will you, kaya sabi ni Lord King Job, when I lay the foundation of the earth, tell me if you have understanding. Who determines its measurement? Surely, you know. Who stretched the line upon it? On what were it the basis sunk or who laid its cornerstone? When the morning stars sung together, yung morning star dyan, together, and all the morning stars sung together.
Angels.
And all the sons of God, Bnei Elohim, shouted for joy. So, in other words, may nauna sa atin, there is a spiritual family and there is a human family. So, God wanted a human family in addition to His supernatural family. Bukod dun sa supernatural family, gusto niya pa ng ano?
Human family.
Human family. Para ang trabaho naman niya ay to manage the physical realm. Ang magmamanage naman ng spirit realm, yung kanyang mga ano? Elohim or something like that. So the story of Eden tells us God wants that his two families to live together in his presence. Kaya naandun si Satanas sa garden. You know, garden is a temple. A garden is a place where human and God meet together. So garden of Eden is an altar. It's a place where God and human meet.
Chamber. Chamber.
Yeah, chamber.
Chamber.
Altar. So this means that just like the angels, human were originally created fit for the presence of God himself. So, from the very beginning, ang tao fit sa presence ni Lord. Hindi siya mamamatay o ano man walang mangyayari sa kanya. That was the original creation. Oh. So, tayo lang yung pinag-create ni Lord na pwede sa spiritual, pwede sa natural. Kaya naalala mo yung angel na nakipag-wrestling kay Jacob. Di ba sabi niya, o Jacob, pakawalan mo na ako kasi sisikat na araw. So may protocol ang mga spirit being, hindi pwede silang abutan ng ano?
Sikat
ng araw. Kaya sa gabi, yung mag ano, mag-take ng physical form. So that is one ano, maaring one of the protocol. Okay? So Genesis begins with the creation. God had done a lot of creating by the time the story gets to people, di ba? First day to sixth day, He God created the heavens and the earth at marami siyang mga ano, ginawa. Pagdating ng sixth day, sa kanya nilika ang tao. So the story unfolds with God creating plant, insect, planting, flying creatures, and land animals. Okay? None of those creatures was capable of having a relationship with God. God knows it. Remember, saan pinag-create ni Lord si Adan? Si Adan? Sa loob ng garden o sa labas ng garden? Sa labas. He was created outside the garden. And then after God created Adam, he was brought inside the ano? The garden. So ang tawag sa atin ay ano? Imagers of God. Now, I'll explain to you later. What is this imagers of God? God decided to fashion new creatures in His image and His likeness. Sabi niya, let us bara, let us create man in our image and our likeness. They would be His earthly family. Kasi meron na siyang spiritual family, gusto pa niya ng ano? Earthly family. So the image of God is an important concept in the Bible. Human beings were created to be like God. Not to be God, but to be like God. Si Satan, ang kasalanan niya, is not about being like God. He wants to replace God. Think of the image of God as a bird. And you're on the right track of understanding the idea. So, imagers of God. Imagers of God.
Magkukopya.
Nangungopya. Or, ano sa English yan? We were created to image God. To be His imagers or to represent Him. Yun ang ibig niyang sabihin. Kinilika niya tayo para i-mirror, i-represent ang Diyos. So pag nakita ka niya, nakita ka ng iba, para nilang nakita ang Diyos sa iyo. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng imagers of God. Alam mo na? Okay. What does it mean to image God? So God created man His own image. In the image of God, He created him, male and female. O, dito pa lang, wala na yung mga bakla at tumboy. O, pinipilit ni Satanas sirain ang image of God because this is the very foundation eh. O, God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth and subdue the earth, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over every living thing that moves on the earth. Imaging God means being God's representation on earth. Kasi ang trabaho natin, pamahalaan ang lupa. Yung kanyang nilikha. And it's very important that you possess the very image of God. So, ang trabaho mo, so Christianity is about imaging God. Representing God. Okay? God tasked humans with doing a job that He could just as well have done Himself. Tama po? Pwede naman gawin ni Lord yun eh. Siya na lang ang mag-image sa sarili niya. Huwag na ang tao. Pero bakit niya ginawa na ibigay pa rin sa tao yan? He wanted His children to participate. Si Lord kasi, pwede man siya na lang gumawa eh. Palagay mo, itong mundong ito, can He transform this world? Yes, in His own way. Pwede niya gawin yan. Pwede bang ma-evangelize ang lahat ng tao at maniwala sa Kanya? Pwede yun. Kaso lang hindi niya gagawin. Bakit? May freedom ang tao. May sarili siyang ano? Kalooban or will. So God's business would be a family business. Ibig sabihin, gusto niya yung kanyang miyembro ng pamilya mag-participate, hindi siya lang. So Eden was not merely God's home. Kasama dyan ano, it was God's home's office. Opisina rin. Why? He has a business that he wants to accomplish. At ang business niya, gusto niya, ang mga anak niya, ang mamahalak ng business niya. Kaya ang negosyo, ang tawag dyan, from the very beginning, is family business yan. Pamilya dapat ang nagmamahala ng negosyo. That's the principle. So, we were created to be God's co-worker. Kaya sabi sa New Testament, we are God's co-worker. Resulta na lang yan. Okay? Now, He shared His attributes. Dahil gusto niya, imidyal tayo, representative niya, He gave us His qualities and abilities. So, yung kakayahan, yung anointing, binigay sa atin, pati yung attributes, yung fruit of the Spirit, ibinigay din sa atin. Even yung creativity, ibinigay din sa atin. Kahit hindi naman siya mga na-discover eh. Diba? Because those things ay galing yung sa Diyos. The Bible tells us that humans are lesser version of who God is. Ano yung ibig sabihin ko? Humans are a lesser version of who God is. Because we... Kasi sabi, He created us in the image and likeness of God. So, lower version tayo. Kaya nga sabi niya, He created us a little lower than the Elohim. Yung kanyang spiritual family, mas mababa doon. Mas mataas sila sa atin. In terms of qualities and abilities. So, He made us to be like Him. Why? So, we could participate with Him as co-rulers, co-caretakers in His new world. Yun ang gusto niya. Hindi magparami lang ng miyembro. Gusto niya ay ano, mag-create ng humans na siyang mamamahala ng mundo. Kasama siya. Kasi ang dominion dapat with God. Ang nangyari, nung mag-rebelde ang tao, they want to take dominion without God. Ganon din ang nangyayari ngayon. Maraming mga simbahan gusto mag-take dominion pero wala ang God. Eh, hindi mangyayari yan. So, imaging God is an important concept. Why? It gave each of us secure and profound identity. Pag naunawaan mo yan, meron kang matatag na identity, hindi ka insecure. You are sons and daughters of God. You are created in the image and likeness of God. You are the lesser version of God. Kaya ano pang ikainggit mo? Di ba? Pangalawa, it is also how we ought to think of people. Ang tingin mo sa iba, kapatid mo. Kaya hindi mo siya magawang saktan. Bakit? Eh, kapatid mo yan eh. Bakit nila nagagawang saktan ang kapwa nila? It is because they don't have what? A secure and profound identity. That they are what? Created in the image of God. Yung kapitbahay mo, yung ibang tao, they are also created by God in the image and likeness of God. Oh, pangatlo, imaging God also give us purpose. So alam mo ngayon ang purpose mo. To reign on earth. To establish the kingdom of God here on earth in His own way. Kaya nga tinuruan tayo ni Lord ng submission eh. Kasi nga, hindi tayo basta nagpipray lamang ng gusto natin. We want what God wants. So one of God's qualities is what? Freedom. What we often call freedom. Yan ang importanteng qualities ng Diyos. Freedom. That God is free. Because of freedom, He set us free. If you have ever wondered why there is evil in the world, here is the answer of the Bible. Tanong. Bakit may evil sa mundo? Diba, kumisan, yung mga biktima ng injustice, ang reklamo nila sa Diyos, bakit hindi pa ginugunaw ng Diyos ang mga masasama? Eh, delikado. Pag tinanggal ni Lord ang lahat ng masama, kasama kang matatanggal. Tama? For all have sinned. Okay? Freedom. Kaya pansinin mo, yung freedom ay importante. Yan yung quality na meron ang Diyos. At ang freedom na yan, binigay sa tao. Tanong, alam ba ng Diyos ang magkakasala ang tao? Alam niya. Pero bakit pinili pa rin ng Diyos na ang tao ay likhain niya in spite na alam niya na ang tao ay magkakamali? The answer is this. He still wants family. Gusto niya ng ano? Pamilya. Okay, tingnan niyo ito. Anak, liyan lang po ito.
He gave instructions to man to tend to and watch over the garden. God took the creation. God formed man from the dust of the earth. He breathed the breath of life into his nostrils, and man became a living person. God planted a garden in Eden and placed the man there. God ordered beautiful trees, and trees that bear fruit to grow up from the ground. In the middle of the garden, He placed the tree of life and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. He gave instructions to the man to tend to and watch over the garden. God told the man, "You may freely eat the fruit of every tree in the garden, except the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. If you eat the fruit of this tree, you will surely die." Then God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper who is just right for him." God brought all the animals to the man to be named by the man. The man gave names to all the animals, but still there was no helper just right for him. So God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. While he slept, God took out one of the man's ribs and closed up the opening. Then he made a woman from the rib, and he brought her to the man. "At last," the man exclaimed, "this one is bone from my bone and flesh from my flesh. She will be called woman because she was taken from man." This explains why a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united into one. Now the man and his wife were both naked, but they felt no shame. One day, the serpent, the most clever of all the wild animals, asked the woman, "Did God really say you must not eat the fruit from any of the trees in the garden?" "Of course we may," the woman replied. "It's only the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden that we are not allowed to eat. God said, you must not eat it or even touch it. If you do, you will die."
"You will not die," the serpent exclaimed.
"God knows that your eyes will be opened as soon as you eat it, and you will be like God, knowing both good and evil." When the serpent was done speaking, the woman did eat the forbidden fruit and shared it with her husband. At that moment, their eyes were opened. They felt shame by their nakedness, so they sewed fig leaves together to cover themselves. That evening, they heard God walking about in the garden, so they hid. God called to the man, "Where are you?" The man replied, "I hid from you because I was naked." "Who told you that you were naked?" God asked. "Have you eaten from the tree whose fruit I commanded you not to eat?" The man replied, "The woman gave it to me." Then God asked the woman, "What have you done?" "The serpent tricked me," she replied. Then God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all animals. You will crawl on your belly as long as you live. I will put hatred and division between you and the woman. He will crush your head and you will bruise his heel." God then said to the woman, "I will sharpen the pain of childbirth, and your husband will rule over you." To the man he said, "Since you listened to your wife and ate from the tree, the ground is cursed because of you. All of your life you will work hard to grow your own food until you die. You were made from dust, and you will return to dust." Adam then named his wife Eve, and God made clothing from animal skins to cover their nakedness. God banished them from the Garden of Eden, and he sent Adam out to cultivate the ground from which he had been made.
When God made the decision to share his attributes with his children, he knew what it meant. God knows everything, so he understands clearly what would happen. He knew that man will make a wrong choice. Alam niya yon. Pero kung siya, hindi siya magkakamali. Kasi God siya. Alam din niya, nung pinag-create niya yung mga Elohim, kasama si Satanas, alam niya na ito, may will din nito, alam din niya magre-rebel din. Naka niyo? God had made the same decision earlier with the heavenly family that He had created. When He created the heavenly family, He gave them free will. So they have abilities like intelligence and freedom. Two, they got those gifts from their Creator. Diba? Si Satan has power. Diba? Oh. Those beings. Diba? God gave them what? Freedom. The same with us. Binigyan din tayo ng ano? Ng freedom. So sooner or later, God knew that His gifts would be either misused or abused. Alam ni Lord Job. Pero pinili pa rin niya na likhain ang tao at bigyan ng ano? Free will. Bakit? He knew full well that though His children in the spiritual world, the Elohim, and on earth, Adam and Eve, were like Him, they were not Him. Okay ba yun? They were like Him, but they were not Him. They were less than Him. They were imperfect, whereas He is perfect. Kaya sabi ko nga, kung si Adan at Eva natukso ni Satanas, tayo pa kaya ngayon? Hello? Diba? He's so convincing. This guy is so beautiful. Kaya naalala niyo, binanggit ko na sa inyo yung Hebrew word na ginamit dyan sa serpent is nakash. Nakash is translated in three meaning. Noun meaning serpent. Adjective, a verb to deceive. That's verb. Yung adjective naman, ang ibig sabihin niya, shining one. So, if you're going to look at the word nakash, ang nakita ni Adam, hindi talaga literal na snake. Kung hindi ano, katulad din niya na nagliliwanag. Diba? They were covered with what? With light before. And he saw this guy also nagsasalita covered with light. Kaya niya pinaniwalaan eh. Diba? Wala naman na kinag-create si Lord sa animal kingdom na nagsasalitang hayop. Diba? So, ang interpretation doon ng meaning ng serpent is not the noun, but the adjective that means shining one. So, they violated God's command to not eat from one of the trees in the garden. So, bakit binigyan ni Lord ng, bakit may tree of knowledge of good and evil? Because God gave, it's a symbolism na they gave them what? Freedom or choice. They sin and lost eternal life in God's presence. So every human being born thereafter was born outside Eden and estranged from God. Nahiwalay sa Diyos. Okay? That was the result. And thus the apostle sum it up, the wages of sin is death. The word death means separation. Estranged. Yan yung naging bunga. Okay? And one of God's supernatural children decided to dishonor God's decision to have a human family by tempting Him. Si Satan nainggit. Sabi ni Lord, let us make man in our image and likeness. Sabi ni Satanas, ayoko nga, may kaagaw pa kami. Oo. Kaya sabi niya, i-eliminate ko ang ano, tao sa plano ng Diyos. So, anong ginawa niya? He tempted Eve, hoping God will destroy her and Adam. That was the thinking of the devil. Akala niya, papatayin ni Lord, i-destroy. Okay? He came to Eve in the form of the serpent. And the Bible referred the serpent as Satan and the devil. So he succeeded in getting into sin, but failed when it comes to getting rid of humanity permanently. Kasi anong ginawa ni Lord? Hindi niya wiped out. Binigyan pa niya ng redemption plan because of his love. Oh, ano sabi niya? Kaya, the question is why is there evil in the world? Evil exists in the world because God decided He wanted to create beings like Himself. Hindi ibig sabihin, it doesn't mean that God has an evil side. Rather, I mean that God rejected the idea of creating humans as robots or pre-programmed computers made of flesh. Yan ang ibig sabihin kung bakit may masama dito sa lupa. Nag-decide si Lord na huwag gawing robot ang tao. Nag-decide si Lord na ang tao ay merong freedom to choose whether to obey Him or disobey Him. So our likeness to Him had to be authentic. Kasi pag sinabi niya, He created you in His image and likeness, dapat totoo yun. Authentic. Kasi kung wala tayong choice and freedom, hindi tayo katulad ng Diyos. Diba? So without the genuine freedom to make real decision, we simply would not be like God. That's why, intentional, nilagay ni Lord yung tree of life and tree of the knowledge of good and evil. That is the expression that sinasabi ni Lord sa tao, I'm giving you freedom to choose to obey me or not to obey me. So God is no robot and we were made to be like Him, not robot. So without genuine free will, we cannot authentically love God or obey God. Kaya hindi pwedeng sundin ng tao ang Diyos na walang free will. Kaya ayaw ni Lord ng plastic. Ayaw ni Lord ng pakitang tao lang. Kasi gusto niya ni Lord yung galing sa iyong kalooban, will mo na i-worship siya. Kaya sabi niya, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind. Kasama yung will. So pag hindi kasama ang will, na winorship mo siya, hindi totoo yan. Kaya ang dami sa simbahan na ganyan. Pakintang tao lang. Hindi kasama yung will sa pag-worship. So the result of all this is that evil exists because people abuse God's wonderful gift. The most important and wonderful gift na binigay ni Lord ay ang will mo. The gift of freedom and use it for self-gratification, ginamit niya, self-revenge, and the mirage of autonomy, this is the abuse begun in Eden. Kaya nga, inaanin lang natin yung nangyari doon sa Garden of Eden. But God was not taken by surprise. Hello? Alam niyo, He had anticipated evil. He foresaw what would happen and planned accordingly. Kaya diba nang sabi niya, God did not destroy His human children for the rebellion. Instead, He would forgive and redeem them. Diba? Sabi pala, I'll create enmity between thy seed and her seed. Doon pa lang, nagplano na ang Diyos ng redemption. Kaya diba sabi niya, ang redemption natin from the foundation of the world. Ang ibig niya sabihin, hindi pa tayo nagkakasala, may ginawa na si Lord na paraan, redemption, because He has a foreknowledge of what will happen to human being. So the plan of salvation would ultimately require God becoming a man. So in effect, God kicked His children out of His house. Okay, temporary lang ito mga anak. Kinipa niya, pinalabas niya. Kasi nga, kung nasa loob sila, kakainin nila yung tree of life, mas hindi na sila masasin. So God also punished Satan. Remember, God did not punish man. What He cursed is Satan. having brought death into God's word, he became Lord of the realm of the dead. And why God didn't just scrap the whole plan for having a human family? Bakit hindi na lang niya inalis yung plano niya yun na magkaroon ng human family? God allowed free will, knowing it would lead to sin and thousands of years of human misery in the form of violence, neglect, selfishness, and a host of other awful things humans are capable of inflicting on one another. Wars, di ba? Murder. Palagay nyo kaya, hindi nasasaktan ng Diyos dyan? Sino ang unang masasaktan? Ang God. Kasi alam niya yan eh. Bago pa lang mangyari, alam niya kung ano mangyayari sa mga tao na nilikha niya in His image and likeness. But God allow it. Why? Perhaps your own suffering or the suffering you see all around you might even make you wish God has just destroyed everything. God can only eliminate evil in our world if He eliminates all the ones who do evil. So, paano yan? In other words, God can only end evil if He wipes out all of us. Because everyone, so while God knew what making us like Him would lead to, the result was preferable to not having a human family at all. So parang ganon. So kung alam lang ng Diyos na yung pagkalita sa tao na katulad niya na may free will ay maglilid lang sa ganitong kasamaan, di sana, hindi na lang niya ginawa. But God sees the sin and misery in our world and knows it cause. It hurts Him. Siya ang unang nasaktan. Bago pa lang magkasala, yung anak mo, di ba, yung nanay ang nasasaktan pag may gumagawang mali ang anak. Pag hindi sinusunod ang anak ang magulang, nag-warning ang magulang because alam nung magulang kung ano mangyayari sa anak. Siya ang unang nasasaktan, hindi yung anak. Same true with our God. He is our Father. So God is so consumed with love for His human children that He will not turn away from His original ambition. He is rather na masaktan kesa hindi niya tayo likain. Mas gugustuhin niya tayo ay masaktan kesa hindi niya tayo makita at mamahal. Hello? Ganyan tayo mamahal ng Diyos. Mas rather na gustuhin niya siya ang unang masaktan kesa hindi niya tayo makita. Ginawa. Why? There is no plan B. There is only plan A. What is the plan A? To create a human family. So despite foreseeing the rebellion that would come in Eden and all the failures and sin that would follow, including our own, God still longs for a human family. Amen? Gusto pa rin niya ng human family. Kaya napansin nyo, pag may nagpipetition sa council, ano na po kasi mo, anak? Sa council, sa langit, pag nagpipetition tayo. Excited sila, di ba?
Oh.
Why they are excited? Because they knew the heavens and earth is becoming what?
United.
And the original plan of God to rule the earth is now being implemented. So what happened in Eden was only the beginning of the story. God had kicked Adam and Eve out of his house. He cursed the serpent and cast him away from his presence. The message was forceful and simple. Rebellion would be punished. Tandaan nyo, God did not curse man. He cursed the land. Yung sa panganak ng babae, it's not a curse. It was a result of being separated from God. Amen? So, we will end here. We'll talk about next week yun. Mas mahaba pa yan. So, klaro, ang Diyos, gusto niya ng pamilya. Pero alam ng Diyos, yung pamilya niya, hindi katulad niya. hindi ka pantay. Katulad niya, pero hindi ka pantay. Alam niya na magkakamali yung pamilya niya sa lupa. Nagkamali na nga. Di ba? But still, tinuloy pa rin niya. Mas gugustuhin pa niya masaktan kesa hindi niya tayo likain. That's the love of the Father. Di ba? Grabe, ang pagmamahal ng Diyos sa tao.
Oh God. Baliktad naman ang tao. Ang tao naman, mamatamisin ka niya, mawala yung kanyang anak, kaysa masira ang damal.
Pride kasi yun eh. But God is different, di ba? Okay. Yung na natin.